Welp, the gang stalker establishment, retard, stupid motherfuckers, losing it big time. These globalists, shout out Dr. Steve. I guess they'll tell him, I don't understand how y'all connected, working together, or at least using the same. But anyway, this is hilarious. I promise you, you could call me again. This is one of those things, I'm going to tell you straight up. You call me whatever. You call me mad. You call me, you know, the old-fashioned mad, you know, like Mad Hatter, or I got too much of an imagination, blah blah blah. I promise you, you're like, just look it up for yourself. One of these little rappers, I guess, supposedly Floyd Mayweather daughter got arrested, and this been going on. But somehow the gang stalker establishment thought it would be a good. I'm telling you, it's a retaliation to what I promise you. You're like, he's 100 million. I know. Trust me, I've been trying to figure. Like I said, in the past, it caused me big problems. I had to get help. Now I just accept it and post these videos to help the whole world. You can say, oh, you're delusional, whatever. Trust me, I'm right. You'll see. Or you could just vibe and laugh at my shit. It's not a commentary. This is, like I said. All right. So you can say, how do you know? Because the little nigga, he made a rapper I never listened to. But you know what? Because he's younger. I might listen to him now. Why? Because I think he has good acting chops. I know he was just because he, first of all, somebody else posted his original video from yesterday. And you can hear in his voice, he's scared. And nobody comments on, he doesn't sound sincere, is what I'm saying. He was trying to talk like me, I promise you. Watch his second video, though, the one where he wakes up, Floyd's daughter, they live together. And he wakes up, and he yelled like I did yesterday, you know. But when I yell, it's because it just hits me. You know, I improvise, I freestyle. I'm not a rapper. I mean, like, freestyle, you know, improvisation. And it just comes out because, like I said, I already come out with a plan on my mind. I'm sitting, I'm watching on a TV or whatever, a movie or whatever. I'm cooking, I'm doing whatever. And you know what? And it hits me. And I come out and I have a plan, and somebody will walk by. You know, you see it all the time. Just like yesterday, somebody will come out, you know, they'll walk down the steps and they'll do this and that. They'll do the entry. So, what I say is natural. Y'all see that. You see it as it unfolds. You see what I'm saying? That's why I let y'all be like, yeah, it's funny. You know, y'all, and you know, that's straight off the top of my head. You know, just like if somebody came out, or if one of the guys, or, you know, not guys, like we're friends, I'm talking about the gang stalkers that come out, you know, like right now on that top, see his door is open. You know, I'll just improvise. I'll go off, and I say that, oh, shit, I went off topic. But, so anyway, he's using phrases stupid. You see how I labeled all my videos yesterday stupid. So this happened last night. So and the guy NBA, that's his name, Young Boy, whatever. Like I said, I'm too old to listen to his music. And he said him and his other rapper, a young one, but he's in jail, Kodak Black. I don't follow all that shit. I didn't even know he was in jail, but all I hear is the other guy using my words. And I'm sorry, these niggas, not sorry for real. These niggas, I don't give a fuck if y'all literally shot somebody. I don't care. Y'all not real. Y'all never been real. He stole my words from yesterday. He's trying to say, and they're too young. That's not that they're too young. It's just a whole nother, y'all too effeminate. I guarantee that the NBA Young Boy, he gay. The Kodak Black, he gay. Not because he in jail, but before the whole thing, the fake shit, he got mad. Remember, I've been saying for the whole time, since my first video, I've been calling these niggas out for watching me. They never really said no response to that. They had their friend. They had all different response to things I say. But there's something set them off yesterday. Whatever I did yesterday, they finally responded to me calling them out. for watching me. Remember, I don't know how many videos. Remember, I said that's what really changed around before about 2015, 14. You know, at that point, I still didn't know what was going on, but, you know, I really had started feeling that's, and I said it one of my, a couple of videos that, these niggas just fight. It had been stopped frightening me. It was annoying, and they were acting like they were, you know, getting over on me or punking me out. I'm like, nigga, you the one that's following me. Remember, I say it all the time. I say it. You're like, well, maybe it's just he's just a street. No. These little young ass niggas. This nigga is not fucking street. He is a fucking actor. See what I'm saying? It doesn't matter. I'm not mad about it. He fucking Floyd daughter. It's supposedly the whole thing. Supposedly because he got a whole bunch of girls, different girls pregnant. The point is, so the Kodak Black little boy, he said something, and he's in jail. And he has a phone in there. Like, how you got a phone? And blah 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 blah. And it started a whole mess. But no, actually it didn't. Like I said. The gang stalker niggas, I think they're getting mad. So it took 2 years of me making these videos. They finally answered to the fact that these niggas following me around. Like you see that they pulling up, they're walking off. I've been saying that, nigga, you a hoe, you a bitch ass nigga. He's really, and these young boys don't talk like that. See what I'm saying? They don't use that type of language. I'm finna go listen to some of his music now because I think he must be talented. The young boy one, because that second video, he sounded like me and he didn't sound scared. But I know it was fake. So hey, you might have a career. You probably go to prison for gang stalking and trying to overthrow the country. But anyway, not just the country, other countries. You're involved with international terrorists. Dumbass nigga, you involved with, you know, that's why I call y'all stupid. That's another thing. I don't call y'all. You see what I'm saying? You trying to say I'm just calling y'all. No, I'm calling y'all stupid because y'all involved. See, you don't understand. This is not about like the town you're from, or this is not about the feds. Y'all motherfuckers are involved with international terrorists trying to take over the New World Order. It's real. So if you was a real banger, if you was all this, your folks would have brought you up on this shit when you was a little kid about the New World Order and all that high shit. You know, when it was high, they would have been talking to you. Oh, you know, they're this and that, and the CIA, they planted crack in the black neighborhoods and all of that, just all of that crazy shit. So that's why I call you stupid. You know what I'm saying? That's why I call you stupid bitch. You know what I'm saying? Had nothing. It because you know, supposedly you're a millionaire and you're fucking with international terrorists. The feds can't save you. The United States can't save you, you little dumb bitch. None of you. That's what I call you stupid for. Stupid motherfucker. Damn, y'all niggas stupid.